Hemant Swensen. Today we are going to see about the heat sinks. What is heat sink? Heat sink is a concept. The name itself that is a device or it is a mechanical device which is connected for the fan system in order to dissipate the heat produced inside the fan system. Power amplifiers covered. In power amplifiers, the most of the segment we are getting the heat. There is a large amount of heat is dissipating from the surface of the transistor. So, in order to protect the transistor protection and heat journey, we have to take certain measures. Measures this call. And measures to intend, first, whatever the heat that is dissipating, we have to connect an extra circuit or extra components. And those components are called as mechanical devices, or simply we call this as heat sinks. Simply, we call this as heat sinks. That is, heat sink is a mechanical device which is connected to the case of the transistor that provides a large surface area. Okay, see here, I am showing the some heat sinks. Heat sink is a mechanical device which is connected to the case of the transistor that provides the large surface area to dissipate the developed heat. And the heat carries towards its surrounding. You can verify on here. So whatever the heat sinks we are showing, these are the different types of heat sinks that is used for different configurations. And any good it depends upon the application. For what for the different applications, we are going to use the different heat sinks. And similarly, the amount of heat dissipating with respect to the transistor, you will calculate what is the heat derating factor, what is the thermal resistance that is offered by the heat sinks. Okay, by calculating those values, we are going to use the different types of heat sinks. That is, in this figure, we have the five types of models for heat sinks that is presented here. You can verify these are the typical heat sinks. Okay, and whatever the junction temperature we are having, certain temperature will be dissipated through the heat sinks. This temperature is called as junction temperature. This junction temperature increases due to the power dissipation. Okay, now the junction temperature ela increase avutundante by the increase in the by the increasing the power dissipation, the junction temperature is increased. This junction temperature is dependent upon the collector dissipation. That is, the whatever the current that is flowing through the collector terminal, that collector terminal dissipation we are taking here. The power dissipation due to heat sink, that is, simply we can indicate this as PD, the power dissipation due to collector dissipation, that is indicated as PD equals to VCE into IC. VC is the voltage drop across collector to emitter, and IC is the collector current. And simply we call this as junction temperature or collector dissipation. And similarly, to calculate these parameters, we are taking certain notations. See, the notations here I have defined, but T suffix capital J is the junction temperature. The junction temperature is indicated as T suffix capital J, that is called as junction temperature. This is due to the power dissipation. And its limit is indicated as minus 65 degrees centigrade to junction temperature, and it is less than TJ max, where TJ max is nothing but the derating factor of the particular transistor. And a transistor complete the burnout and a maximum operating temperature and the operate. And if the temperature is greater than TJ max, then the particular transistor will burn out, and that transistor will kalipothundi. And within this range, that is within the range of minus 65 to less than junction temperature, less than junction temperature maximum value. The maximum value should be up to this maximum value, we can operate the particular transistor. Okay. Similarly, it is necessary to keep TJ is always less than TJ max. Simply, what is TJ? And TJ is nothing but junction temperature. This is the power dissipation due to the collector dissipation approach. Okay, what are the advantages of this heat sinks? Heat sinks okay, advantages and apple, which is the temperature of the case gets lower. And temperature of the case automatically decreases due to the attached heat sink. And transistor pine screws to a attachment or heat sinks produce. These heat sinks will reduce the temperature. Similarly, the power handling capability of the transistor can approach the rated maximum value. And the power handling capability and the chipchan TJ maximum or operate chess designate chess. Okay, you can see here one transistor that is connected with the heat sink I am highlighting. This is the transistor. This is actually regulator now. And a tube. But similarly, the power transistors are also in this size. These power transistors are connected with the heat sinks. Okay, like this, the arrangements will be made. Due to the junction temperature increasing, this increased temperature is dissipated via these heat sinks. Okay, via these heat sinks. See, what are the types? The types of heat sinks in figure. If you observe the figure A and B, these are natural and conventional coolers. Okay, the first two figures. If you observe these first two, these are natural. And these two are natural and conventional coolers, and the remaining three are the typical shape. And typical shape, that is a dissipator, which will have variation depending upon the amount of heat. The different structures for heat sinks. These heat sinks are connected across junction bodies of the transistor. Okay. It, I think you have observed in many cases on heat sinks and anything, which is all can be stored a regulator on necessary, like the TV or stabilizer on necessary, which is the transformer. The Gargani, you are having the heat sinks like this. These heat sinks are generally used to dissipate the heat that is developed inside the transistors. Okay, this is about the heat sinks. Think a limitable level of is known as PD equals to VC into IC. Okay, simply, what is the heat sink? Heat sink is a mechanical device which is connected to the case of the transistor that provides large surface area to dissipate the developed heat, and the heat, this heat carries heat to the surroundings. Okay, this heat is dissipated to the surroundings. Okay, this is about the heat sinks. Now we are going to further designing of heat sink. Generally, into the exam point of what is heat sink, what is the design of heat sink, okay, or develop the thermal and electrical relation for the heat sink. They were asking for derive the relation for thermal and electrical relation for the heat sink. Okay, see here, the heat sink design is described like this. Heat dissipation problem is very much similar to the electric circuits and Ohm's law. Like heat dissipation problem, it is very similar to the Ohm's law, or it is very similar to the electric circuit. And electric circuit behavior similarly, the electric current flows when there exists a potential difference. Okay, electric current produces of the, there is a potential difference between the two terminals, then electric current will be developed across the network. Similarly, while heat flows when there is when there exists a temperature difference, heat produces of the temperature difference and lower temperature into higher temperature region, heat flow is zero. Similarly, higher temperature into lower temperature, heat flow is zero. That is, if there is a heat, similarly, heat flow will happen when there is a when there exists a temperature difference. The temperature difference is indicated as T2 minus T1. That is higher temperature minus lower temperature, T2 minus T1. Similarly, we are defining one more parameter called thermal resistance. What is it? Voltage is V equals to IR, where R is the resistance and ohms. Similarly, thermal behavior, we are calling the resistance as thermal resistance. The thermal resistance is indicated as theta. Thermal resistance is indicated as theta. The theta is nothing but it is the difference between T2 minus T1 by PD. What is PD, Nana? It is a collector dissipation. PD, we have given it as VCE into IC. And a transistor is connected to power dissipation across the collector terminal. That is PD equals to VCE into IC. What are the units? If you verify the units here, the units are per degree centigrade per watt. Or degree centigrade per milliwatt, where PD is the heat dissipated due to the power dissipation. Okay. Similarly, the PD can be, from this relation, we can write PD equals to T2 minus T1 by theta. T2 minus T1 by theta. PD is nothing but T2 minus T1 by theta, that is milliwatts. That is, for designing of this heat sink, we are going to find the analogy between the thermal electricity and thermal and electrical analogy. For that, I am taking this figure. Now, if you observe this figure, this is a heat sink. This is a heat sink. Here, in this heat sink, you can observe this is the transistor. The power transistor here indicated this is power transistor. And this is the space that is connected between power transistor and heat sink. And heat sink, power transistor connected in place. Similarly, and this is the heat flow. And heat, another the power transistor generated. This heat flow will be transmitted through the heat sink like in different directions. Now we will see what are the different parameters here. Here we are having the theta. What is the theta? And thermal resistance. Thermal resistance from the device to the case. Okay. Thermal resistance from the device to the case, we are indicating with theta device case. Similarly, thermal resistance. Thermal resistance between the sink and air. Air and ambient. Ambient heat sink ninchi out of the surroundings. We are calling that thermal resistance between sink and air, which is indicated theta sink hyphen air. Air is nothing but ambient. Similarly, the heat thermal resistance between the case and sink. The case and sink. Case and tena, case is nothing but transistor case. Nana. Sink and the heat sink. Nana. Okay. These three parameters you have to identify. And similarly, you can see here the power transistor, heat flow, theta device case, and space between the and heat theta case and sink, theta sink and air, and theta device and case. These are different notations we are using here. If you now you can verify these definitions. Definitions you can see here theta. Wait 1 second. You can verify here this parameter. This with the heat flow from the power transistor is indicated like this with a different resistance. Heat flow from the transistor is this is your junction transistor. The heat flow is indicated with the different parameters. These parameters, the first one is TA. TA is nothing but we are indicating T is for temperature. Now. A is indicating for ambient. Ambient ambient temperature. Where TJ is the junction temperature, TC is the case temperature. TC is the case temperature. TJ is the junction temperature. TC is the case temperature. TJ is the ambient temperature. J for junction, C for case, A for ambient. Similarly, theta JA, this is the thermal resistance. The total thermal resistance between J and A, J and junction and ambient. Junction ki air ki majjalo unna total thermal resistance and junction nunchi air loki enta dissipate ayindi, what is the thermal resistance that is offered between junction and air, that is the first parameter. Similarly, the total thermal resistance between junction and case, and junction nunchi case ki enta vachindi check chesukuntam, that is junction and case. Similarly, third one, thermal resistance, that is between the case and heat sink. Case ki heat sink and manaki insulator and space chupichanu inda figure lo meer observe chesthe, you can observe here there is a space between the case and junction, and this is indicated with the theta cs, that is indicated with theta cs, that is theta cs is equals to, that is the insulator thermal resistance between case and between the case and the heat sink, between the case and heat sink. And the last one is heat sink thermal resistance, that is heat sink thermal resistance, that is called as the, it is the thermal resistance between sink and ambient. Okay, we will verify all these parameters. If you observe this figure, the figure may observe chain nano, sorry, in this figure you can identify that, in this figure you can identify the total parameters. The first parameter is indicating this heat TJ, junction temperature, case temperature, sink temperature, ambient temperature. TJ is the junction temperature, TC is the case temperature, TS is the sink temperature, and TA is the ambient temperature. Now we have to verify the TJ between TA. And then TJ ninchi TA came from theta JA, that is thermal resistance between junction and ambient. Theta JA is the thermal resistance between junction and ambient. Ambient, to calculate this parameter, we are taking each and every parameter, is the theta JC, junction into case can be, tarvata case into sink can be, tarvata sink to ambient. By this we can write theta JA equals to theta JA equals to the sum of theta JC, theta CS, theta SC. Okay, these are the parameters. This is the relation that we are getting from this figure. This is the figure that is showing the heat flow from the power transistor. That is the heat flow that is generating from the power transistor. Okay. Now, by taking this figure, you can verify. From the heat flow diagram, an electrical analogy and electrical relation can be obtained. It is just like a simple series circuit. What we have said, the theta jj equals to the sum of the junction thermal resistances. That is theta jj equals to theta jc plus theta cs theta sc. Therefore, we can write wherever it is required, the theta j is the thermal resistance between junction and ambient that is obtained with respect to the junction and case and sink and air. Similarly, we know theta jj is nothing but T2 minus T1 in the relation. That is simply we can write theta equals to junction temperature minus ambient temperature, Tj minus Ta divided by power dissipation. Tj minus Ta by power dissipation. We know what is Tj. From this relation, we can write the relation in terms of Tj like this. Tj equals to Pd into theta Ja plus Ta. And ikkada em chestunna okasa verify cheyandi. That is, we are going to write the relation, the total power handling capability. The total power handling capability of the device is obtained as Pd. That is, the total power handling, power dissipated, Pd equals to theta Ja minus theta A divided by this value. Okay? The E relation is theta Ja relation substitutes. That is, this relation is substituted here in place of theta Ja. Okay? In place of theta J, we are substituting this relation here. Therefore, we are getting that Pd equals to Tj minus Ta by theta Jc junction 2 case, theta case 2 sink, theta sink 2 A. Similarly, the temperature of case and sink. If we temperature of case and sink, we are getting the temperature for theta Jj. First relation, we have taken the relation for theta Jj here. Similarly, now we are taking the relation of theta sink to ambient, theta sink to case. And a pretty relation could rasp possibility. Therefore, this relation theta Cs equals to Tc minus Ts by Pd, theta Sa equals to Ts minus Ta by Pd, where by adding these two values, we can directly get theta C minus theta A by Pd. And manaki oka relation nunchi inko relation teesukodam possibility undi. Okay. Like this, we can write the manufacturers usually specify the total thermal resistance from the case to air, theta C A for the heat sink. What e relation ichinappudu deenni teesukonam theta C A teesukondi. Okay. By taking these relations, we can do one problem, but problem will be discussed later now. Meanwhile, we will verify one more definition. That is called derating factor. And the problem chase we will verify that. What is that derating factor? Derating factor data verify it. And in the chapter, Tj max in Japan, the device can be operated between minus 65 degrees less than junction temperature less than maximum junction temperature Tj max. That is called as derating factor. What is derating factor? See here in this figure, we can see. Practically, junction temperature increases, the power handling capability of the transistor decreases. And the junction temperature increases, the power handling capacity of the transistor will be decreasing. Transistor heat ekkuva dissipate avutundi, power handling capability of the transistor avutundi, transistor performance decrease. Simply we are calling this as the junction temperature increases, the power handling capacity of the transistor will decrease. Thus, it is necessary to derate the power handling capacity of the power transistor as the function of case temperature. That is, it is necessary to derate the power handling capacity of the power transistor as the function of case temperature. Such as the derating is possible by providing derating curve of the transistor. If you observe this curve, here we are having the rated power. Here we are having the rated power. We are having the rated power. The rated power is indicated as P rate. That is, like this. That is, we are taking the plot between PT versus temperature of the case. If you observe the power delivered to the transistor P rated, this as the junction temperature, the case temperature is increasing. As the case temperature is increasing, this is up to the room temperature where the power dissipation is normal. Okay, and similarly, this is getting derating. The power handling capacity of the transistor is gradually decreasing. Whenever this case temperature is this temperature is greater than TJ maximum handling capacity, then the transistor will be damaged. And if you మనకు టీకేస్ అనేది టీజే మ్యాక్స్ కన్నా కూడా ఎక్కువ అయిపోతుంది. ఓకే, వెన్ ద ఆపరేటింగ్ టెంపరేచర్ ఇస్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ టీజే మ్యాక్సిమం, దెన్ ద ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ విల్ బర్న్ అవుట్. ఓకే, దెన్ ద ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ విల్ బి బర్నింగ్ అవుట్. దట్ ఈస్ హియర్ వి సింప్లీ సేయింగ్ దట్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ కర్వ్ వి కెన్ సీ సచ్ డీరేటింగ్ కర్వ్ ఇస్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ బై ద, అంటే ఈ కర్వ్ ఎవరు ఇస్తారు అంటే ఈ కర్వ్ మనం తీసుకున్న ఆపరేషన్ బట్టి డిపెండ్ అవుతుంది. ఇట్ ఈస్ టేకన్ ఫ్రమ్ ద మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరర్. Manufacturer will provide this curve in the data, in their data sheet. And particular transistor ఏ రీజియన్ లో ఆపరేట్ అవ్వాలి, ఏ రీజియన్ నుంచి ఏ రీజియన్ వరకు మనం వోల్టేజ్ సప్లై చేయొచ్చు, కరెంట్ సప్లై చేయొచ్చు, పవర్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్ ఎలా తీసుకోవచ్చు, అన్ని కూడా డేటా షీట్ లో ఉంటాయి. ఇన్ దట్ డేటా షీట్ దే విల్ ప్రొవైడ్ దిస్ డీరేటింగ్ కర్వ్, అంటే ఎక్కడ వరకు ఆపరేట్ చేయొచ్చు, వాట్ ఈస్ ద మ్యాక్సిమం టెంపరేచర్ దట్ కెన్ బి డెలివర్డ్ బై ద ట్రాన్సిస్టర్, అంటే ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ ఎంత హీట్ ని ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేయగలుగుతుంది, అంతకన్నా ఎక్కువ హీట్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ అయితే ఖచ్చితంగా డివైస్ అనేది ఫెయిల్యూర్ అవుతుంది. Such a derating curve is provided by the manufacturer. ఇలాంటి కర్వ్ ఎవరు ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తారు, మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చర్ ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తారు. సిమిలర్లీ, వాట్ డస్ దిస్ కర్వ్ ఇండికేట్? ద సేఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ పవర్ దట్ డివైస్ కెన్ హ్యాండిల్ వెన్ కేస్ టెంపరేచర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ద రూమ్ టెంపరేచర్. అంటే ఇది ఏం ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తుంది? సేఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ పవర్ దట్ సేఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రికల్ ఆపరేటింగ్ పవర్ దట్ ఈస్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ బై ద డివైస్ ఎట్ రూమ్ టెంపరేచర్ అంతా చూపిస్తుంది. అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ రేటెడ్ పవర్ హ్యాండ్లింగ్ కేపబిలిటీ. Or rated power handling capacity, that is indicated as P rated. P rated ante enti? The safe electrical power the device can handle when case temperature is equal to the room temperature T naught, and it is called as rated power handling capacity P rated. Similarly, the temperature at which the derating curve crosses this maximum allowable junction temperature, the temperature at which the derating curve crosses the maximum allowable junction temperature TJ max, if TKS is beyond the TJ max, then transistor will be damaged. If damage avutundana, when the temperature of the case is greater than TJ max, the maximum temperature kanna daarthe matra, then the transistor will get damaged. And its governing relations, the relations gurtu pettukona, just conclusions kanda, the power dissipation PD of the temperature T1 and two temperatures madhyalo ichinappudu PD of T1 equals to PD of T0 minus T1 minus T0. It is called as derating current, derating power, and power derating relation is given as PD of T1 equals to PD of T0. T0 is nothing but room temperature minus T1 minus T0, where PD of T0 is rated power handling capacity at temperature T0. PD of T1 is the rated power handling capacity of temperature T1. Because now temperature T1 and A, this can be equal to the TJ maximum or it can be less than the TJ max. If the T1 is greater than TJ maximum, we can simply say that the power transistor is damaged and the power transistor will be damaged. Okay, this is about the derating curve. Okay, derating curve ante enti kada chudandi, derating factor anna enti and what is its graph and what is its relation, and this is about the heat sinks. Okay, హీట్ సెన్స్ అంటే ఏంటో చూడండి, అంటే ప్రాబ్లం వచ్చిన సేమ్ ఆ ఫార్ములా వస్తుంది, ఆ ఫార్ములా సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకుంటే ప్రాబ్లం వస్తుంది, ఒకసారి అది మీరు చెక్ చేయండి. ఎనీ డౌట్స్ నాన్న ఒకసారి? ఓకే, దిస్ ఇస్ ద పవర్ యాంప్లిఫైర్. క్లాసిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ పవర్ యాంప్లిఫైర్స్, ఇన్ దిస్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ ద ఆల్ ద క్లాసిఫికేషన్స్, క్లాస్ ఏ, క్లాస్ బి, క్లాస్ సి అండ్ క్లాస్ ఏబి. ఓకే, సిమిలర్లీ వీ హ్యావ్ వెరిఫైడ్ క్లాస్ ఏ పవర్ యాంప్లిఫైర్. క్లాస్ ఏ పవర్ యాంప్లిఫైర్లో సిరీస్ ఫెడ్ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మర్ చెక్ చేసుకున్నాం, తర్వాత క్లాస్ బి చూపించాను. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ ద పుష్పుల్ యాంప్లిఫైర్స్. దిస్ ఈస్ డ్యూ టు పుష్పుల్ యాంప్లిఫైర్స్ ఎందుకు డిస్కస్ చేసామంటే, ద డిసడ్వాంటేజెస్ ఇన్ క్లాస్ బి, దట్ ఈస్ హార్మోనిక్ డిస్టార్షన్స్ అనేది క్లాస్ బిలో ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి పుష్పుల్ యాంప్లిఫైర్ కాన్సెప్ట్కి వచ్చాం. In push-pull amplifier, we have verified the class A push-pull amplifier. After that, we have seen the class B push-pull amplifier. Now, what are the disadvantages in class B push-pull amplifier? We are going for the complementary symmetry. Disadvantage in Hanakada, we are using two center tap transformers are used for push-pull amplifiers. To eliminate the center taps, we are going for the complementary symmetry push-pull amplifier. In that, we have verified class AB, complementary symmetry push-pull amplifier. Okay. General class C power amplifier also ledana. Class C power amplifier and class AB equal ground. If necessary, I will discuss that also. And then after that, we have verified the thermal stability and heat sinks. Heat sinks if we verify chesana, what is heat sink and what is the thermal stability and what is the derating factor. Okay. With this, we have completed the 5th unit lo power amplifier topic complete type. And we have left with the tuned amplifiers. Already problems discussed chesanana. Okasari meeru kuda problems check cheyandi. If you have any doubt in the problems, please ask me. Problems ledana doubts unte okasari meeru adagandi. Okay. Problems ledana doubts unte okasari adagandi. Okay. I think from the next week we will start the 4th unit on oscillators. Oscillators chala easy ga untundi. Mostly this topic will be explained by the Veer Raju sir. Sir okavela divide cheddam ante evar section vallu cheptam ledha ante combined ga meeku sir cheptanu. And we have left with one more class under class undi. Meeku e doubts unna sare aa doubts ni adagandi. I will clarify regarding the power amplifiers. Power amplifiers and doubts ni adagandi. Ledante example problems evanu ante I will explain chestanu. Okay.